is how to soil sample. So let's talk to folks today about how to do that.
That's a great idea, Stephanie. Now is a great time of year to do soil samples, and it would work in any kind of landscape, whether you have turf or ornamentals. Landscape area soil sampling can help you find out what fertility issues your ground might have and how we can help make recommendations to help your lawn or garden or plants be better able to grow and thrive.
So what kind of tools do we need?
Well, you're holding one right there. That's probably the most important one.
This right here?
Yeah, so this is your handy dandy soil probe. And when you're taking a soil sample, you'll want to make sure that you go down at least 2 to 4 inches to make sure that you get any soil that would be in the root zone of any plants that you're trying to sample for. So something else you're going to need is a bucket. So when you go around and collect your soil samples, you're going to want to make sure that you are taking representative samples around the area. And I usually recommend at least 10 to 15 of the little plugs that you would gather with that soil probe and make sure that it represents an entire area. And then collect all those samples in the bucket so that you can mix that up later and put it into a soil sample.
So I would think with all the rain we've had this year, we should be able to get a pretty good sample. In drought years, it's been kind of tough, but this year it should be okay.
Yeah, hopefully the ground is soft enough where we can get a soil sample today.
Let's give it a shot.
So that looks like a pretty good one right there. So once you've collected your soil sample, what do you have to do then, Stephanie?
You have to bring that soil sample to your local county extension office.
Awesome. And what do they need to bring it in?
They need to bring that soil sample to us in a soil sample bag. Or if you don't have time to come by the extension office to pick up a bag, you can bring that soil to us in any type of Ziploc style bag, and then we can transfer it to the soil sample bag once you arrive.
Sure, I'll tell folks, usually a sandwich size Ziploc bag would hold enough soil for us to put in a soil sample. And when you're filling out your information for your soil sample, especially if you're doing more than one, there's information or spots here on your bag where you can label it with your name and address. Also, the sample ID, so we'll be able to know, and you'll be able to know, which spot that sample and those results are going to be related to for down the road when you're looking at your report and we're helping you with the recommendations.
Yeah, there's nothing more frustrating to a client than to bring in the information. They brought in 3 samples, but they didn't mark them so that they knew where they took them.
And then we have to do it all over.
Exactly.
So we hope this information has helped you know a little bit more about soil sampling. Feel free to call your local extension agent for more information.